So one of the most useful parts of iOS is the Control Center. But a lot of people don't use it very much. You really should get used to using it. It's a great way to access many of the functions on your iPhone and iPad. On the iPhone X here, you just drag down from the top right corner of the screen to bring up Control Center. Now there's some default things in here like the ability to control your music, go into airplane mode, turn on Do Not Disturb, adjust volume and screen brightness. But in addition to that, there are these buttons at the bottom that are customizable. So you should familiarize yourself with the ones that you have there. Like for instance, the ability to turn a flashlight on, change the font size, go to the camera app or calculator app, start a stopwatch. All of that's there. But you should also not ignore the ones that you may not have added. If you go into settings, and under settings you look for Control Center, you'll see customize controls. And here you'll see at the top the ones that are already included. So I can see them and I can see actually what they're called in addition to their icons. So for instance I can see that the red one is called screen recording and that's for screen recording. But there's a whole bunch more at the bottom. And this will depend upon which model you're looking at. You know, iPhone or iPad and which model of iPhone. So there's a whole bunch of stuff in here. For instance you can turn on Do Not Disturb While Driving with this. You can go to the Home app. You can turn on Low Power Mode. Turn it on and off really easily. The magnifier. You can jump to notes. You can scan a QR code. Go to a stopwatch. Go to voice memos. Even access your wallet here inside of Control Center as long as you enable these. So just tap one to add it. So if I wanted to tap alarm there, you can see now it's added here. I can also drag the little three line handle on the right to move them around and set the order for them. So now that I've added alarm here, I can go home again and I can see alarm has been added there. So it's really handy. And here on my older iPad Pro I see there are slightly different ones available there. So go through these as well. Whatever device you've got, I encourage you to actually go through each one of these, add them, maybe add them all and just try them out and then remove the ones you don't think you'll use. Because it really could be handy and much better experience using your iOS device if you have the right buttons in Control Center and you know what they are and you start using them.